here at THS. Summer Hart is one of our other counselors, but she's heading up one of the other presentations right now. And then Mrs. Smith is actually helping up in the booth with the presentation. So I'm going to go ahead and just get started. Go over this information. I'm going to go through everything, and then I just ask that if you have a really burning question on the slide when I get to it, feel free to, you know, just raise your hand or shout out your question. I just want to get through all the information because I know a lot of you maybe you have students that are already at THS, or maybe this is your first student coming up to the building. I just want to make sure I get through everything tonight. So the counseling staff. Ms. Everhart is our counselor that has last names A through F. So we are separated by alphabet here. I know the middle school, they have one counselor, so that's who they report to. And here at the high school, we are by last names. So that's who you would usually correspond with. If you had questions about your student's schedule or, you know, anything with college applications, once they get closer to junior, senior year, but we do have different responsibilities also. So Ms. Everhart is our main testing coordinator. So she does all the ACT testing, the AP testing, and of course, testing. And also she does NCAA for those of you, or if your child is interested in participating in college athletics. She's the coordinator of that. And then, very important for your child's senior year, she does the scholarships, posting them, coordinating them with the local community agencies that help support that. I am Mrs. Schmidt. I serve last names G through O. I am the liaison between us and the Career Technical Center. So even if your student doesn't fall on my caseload, and if you have specific questions about Miami Valley CTC, I can certainly help you with that. I'm also the career college coordinator. Haven't been able to do too much of this in the past couple of years because this involves more of reps coming into the building, us doing more field trips, job shadowing, college campus visits. I coordinate all of those. I don't have this on here, but I'm also the Hope Squad advisor. If you hear about Hope Squad, I co-advise that group with a teacher here at Tippecanoe. Then we have Mrs. Smith. Again, she's up in the booth helping me out. She serves the end of the alphabet, last names P through Z. She does coordinate the PSAT test that's offered in the fall, and she's also our College Credit Plus coordinator. So if you are attending that presentation at 6, you will see her, and she will talk about our College Credit Plus program here at TIP. Our secretary, Mrs. Geyer, very helpful to our staff. She does everything with enrolling, withdrawing paperwork. She does help with Jostens and getting with orders, caps and gowns, rings, all of that good stuff. And then just really helps assist the counseling and administrative team. For any students in here, I think I talked to you guys about, you know, when you come into the counseling office, Mrs. Geyer will be the first person you see, and she'll direct you to where you need to go. So credit-wise, so if you were in the last presentation about graduation requirements, I really focused on the testing piece because that was the main goal of that presentation. But today we want to talk about scheduling and what credits you need to graduate. So here's just kind of a quick snapshot here. 4 credits of English, 4 in math, 3 science, 3 social studies, 1/2 a credit, which is a semester long in health, 1/2 a credit of PE or the PE waiver, which I will explain that when we get to that slide. A fine art credit, 1/2 credit in personal finance, career connections, which is new starting with this class, so the class of 2026, the career connections 1/2 credit, and then electives 4 credits, totaling to that 21 credits. So just to kind of give you what does this look like, we are a 7 period day here at the high school. So freshman year, and then this just shows that, you know, you would take an English class, it's a year-long course, you're earning a credit. Same with math, science, all freshmen take biology, and then I'll talk to you about what are the different levels of biology that are available. Social studies, world history, or AP human geography. Health, which is a 1/2-year course. half-year course along with PE semester, and then optional study hall. Every student has the option to take either a half or full-year study hall. You cannot have more than that. You cannot have more than two study halls per year, one per semester. So then I think it's important to kind of see the projection, because as I told the incoming freshmen when we met with them, the high school counselors went over to the middle school. Hopefully your son or daughter told you that we were there talking to them about scheduling and information about the high school. Freshman year is pretty tight as far as scheduling. We don't have a lot of wiggle room, okay? And so we want students to see, you know, sometimes that can be overwhelming. Like, you look through the program of studies and, wow, there's a lot I want to take and I don't have a lot of time. We want you to see that as your time progresses here at TIP, you will start to open up a little more. So sophomore, you still have to take that English, math, science, social studies. And social studies is either American history or AP World. If you haven't already taken that career connections course, you want to get that completed along with your PE. We strongly recommend you get PE done by the end of your sophomore year. A big reason for that is if you want to go to the Career Technical Center, which would be your 11th to 12th grade year, they don't offer PE. And if you don't get it done, then the only way to get it done through CTC is to do an online program. There's a cost to that. The other reason is I haven't met a junior or senior who loved the idea of being in a PE class with all freshmen. Okay, so I would just really recommend you get that done your freshman or sophomore year. You have a little bit more time for an elective. Maybe you want to get your fine art credit out of the way. And then study hall. Junior year, English, again, still need that third credit English. Math, you're either taking Algebra 2 or Math 11, or if you are accelerated past that, you might be in pre-calc as a junior, an AP class as a junior. Science, you have more of a choice of what advanced science you take. Social studies, you could be taking government, or you could be taking one of our social studies elective courses. In 11th grade, that's when you have the opportunity to take a personal finance class that you need to graduate. More electives and a study hall if you so choose. And then finally, your senior year, you'll see again, you kind of start to see you have more room for those electives. Okay, so again, just kind of want to show the projection. I don't want to get too caught up in this because we just want to focus on freshman year, what to schedule, what's the appropriate level for your son or daughter for a certain subject. But like I said, it can be overwhelming to see, oh my gosh, I don't even have a choice of an elective to take. You will, okay? You will as your time goes on here at TIP. So, program of studies, this is on our website. It is, when you go under the high school website and you go to the school counseling page, it'll say program of studies, it'll say 2022, 2023. Is there a way you can click on that link? Smith, I don't know if that's be able to zoom back. So this is our counseling website, program of studies on the left. We hit the plus. So we have last year's, but then we have this year's up there. This is what it looks like. You want to scroll through? Great. Table of contents. So I would definitely look at this as far as like course descriptions. If you notice at the top, career pathways, that can be very helpful. What we decided to do last year is we put finance, business. If you're interested in this career pathway, here are math classes you should take. Here are some electives you should take. So I strongly encourage if your son or daughter has a pathway in mind, like they want to go into the medical field, they want to go into business, they want to go into engineering, you want to look at that. Because they will, we have given you some, this was input from us as counselors, input from the teachers that teach the courses. So really this program of studies, although a lengthy document, is really important, especially as you and your child get acclimated to the high school and what our curriculum is. And you really want to read, the teachers put a lot of effort into their course descriptions. What are the prereqs for this class? What are we going to do in this class? So make sure that when you're choosing electives, make sure when you're choosing what level of biology you want your son or daughter to be in, that you're reading the differences, because that's why we put it there to give you guys as much here's what I was talking about, some health sciences, what are the, you're interested in that, what are some careers, what are some suggested courses here in the high school, okay? So again, program of studies on the school counseling website. School counseling website, a great place for you, a great resource for you. We have things from career planning to scholarships to program of studies to mental health resources. English. So I'm going to talk about each content area one by one. So again, English, you need 4 credits to graduate. We have 3 levels, and this is based on teacher recommendation. So this is based on your son or daughter's current 8th grade teacher for language arts. They put in a recommendation to the computer. They've already done that. When your son or daughter goes to schedule, the scheduling portal, they will see what they were recommended for bolded, okay? Now, if they were recommended for accelerated, the option to pick accelerated or CP should be available. Okay, but it would be bolded which one they were recommended for, okay? So when they go to schedule, they will see that recommendation. What are the differences? So we have the general, we have college prep. So I would say any student that is planning to go to a four-year college would want to start on the college prep track, get that understanding of reading and writing to prepare for college. And then we also have accelerated, that does include a summer assignment. I do have copies of what last year's summer assignment was, so if that's something you're interested in after the presentation, you can come see me, because again, that doesn't mean it's not subject to change. But we want you to be prepared of what the summer work would look like. So again, a little bit more about accelerated English. Mr. Porto, did you want to stand up and did you want to say anything here? Tells you what it is. It's reading excerpts, certain chapters from a mythology book, and they will have a test over the material in the first few days of school. Other considerations that the class, obviously being accelerated, goes at a faster pace. They're reading and writing outside of class. Okay, so again, just things to consider. I agree with Mr. Porto. We're not trying to scare you off in any means. We're just trying to give you all the information so that you can make the most informed choices. So this one is a little more tricky because it kind of depends. It depends on where you are now as an 8th grader, what math you're in. I think the 8th grade math is called pre-algebra, so that's what I have on there. And then it's also dependent on your teacher recommendation. So there's 2 things that go into the math choice. If you're an 8th grade pre-algebra, your teacher will either recommend you for algebra or algebra 1 lab class or college prep algebra 1. If you're currently in Algebra 1 as an 8th grader, your teacher will recommend you for either college prep geometry or accelerated geometry. If you're in accelerated geometry as an 8th grader, your teacher would recommend you for either accelerated Algebra 2 or college prep Algebra 2. Mr. Malott, did you want to say anything about math that didn't Science. We have, so remember, three credits of science, but they're very specific. We have biology is freshman year. Sophomore year is chemistry or earth science. And your junior or senior year is advanced science class. You get to choose. So there's earth science, there's anatomy, there's AP bio, AP chem, physics. And then ninth grade option, very similar to English. There's three levels. Okay, there is the general biology course, college prep, or accelerated biology. And again, a couple things. Ninth grade placements depend on a student's current math course and their science teacher recommendation. So they, you know, if a kid is an accelerated math, the teacher and the science teacher, they're probably going to put them in an accelerated biology class. They want to make sure that they're on that right level of being accelerated and staying accelerated, especially as we move on to chemistry and those other science courses. So accelerated biology, there is summer work for this course as well. Again, not meant to scare you, but start thinking if you're someone that you are taking multiple accelerated classes, you are going to have multiple summer assignments, okay? And again, it's summer supposed to be a break for everyone, for staff, for students. So just kind of be aware when you have summer plans or a summer job or whatever it may be, that if you are signing up for three accelerated courses, that these things will all be on your plate. Summer work includes graphing, biology vocabulary, critical thinking questions, and then other work that will be covered right at the beginning of the school year. Other things to think about, a faster pace, more, there's probably going to be a little bit more homework, more reading. Science teachers, did you guys have anything to add that I missed? Social studies. So again, three credits, very specific. You need a world history credit. American history and government. Our ninth grade options are AP Human Geo, which is by teacher recommendation. So teacher, you have to be recommended to take the AP course. And again, those recommendations are already in PowerSchool for your students. And then we have our world history course. AP Human Geography, did you want to talk about this? Okay.
My name is Mr. Zerbel. I teach ninth grade AP Human Geography. For us, we're similar to the other AP and accelerated classes. We do have summer work, but for us, it's just some maps, some world maps that you'll do, and basically that sets the foundation for what comes next in the class. Most of our class, after we get through, I think, the second chapter, a lot of it is focused on where things are throughout the world, but not necessarily location, but like, why are they there? What are they there for? So we start to look at locations throughout the globe. We look at their politics, their economics, ethnic, racial, religious backgrounds. So it's more like the why to where places are, not so much like just doing maps all day and studying maps all day. And again, we do that during the summer for the summer work. And there's examples of that up here now in the lobby. But again, it's more just kind of why relates to where they are and the dynamics of that. So if your student's interested, I would love to have them be part of the class. I would argue that the class isn't overly difficult, but there is probably a little bit of added work in terms of the workload. So if you're a student that doesn't have the best work ethic, it might be a little bit challenging, but as long as you're up to doing a little bit of extra work, maybe a little bit more, then you should be just fine. So again, I'm Mr. Zerbel. If you have any questions, I'll be able to.
And one thing I just want to cover before we move into electives is if your child is recommended for a course, like let's say, you know, you heard just now about AP Human Geography, you think that'd be a great fit for you, if you're the student here, or if you're the parent, you think that'd be a good fit for your child, but your student wasn't recommended for it, that's a conversation that would need to be had with their current teacher. So in that case, current social studies. And maybe talk about how, because maybe they were on the fence, and you know, the teacher just thought, well, they're freshman year, I'm just going to go ahead and recommend them for world history, and you know, maybe test the waters, and the following year, maybe they could be in the AP track. If there's a disagreement with what your child was recommended for, I would start those conversations with your student's current teacher, their eighth grade teacher, just because they're the ones who made the recommendation. we're going to talk about electives that students could consider. Art classes, Intro to Art 1. Now, this is a class that some kids are able to take at the middle school, so just make sure that if you're taking Art 1 or you're taking it now, don't sign up for Art 1. You're going to sign up for Art 2 if you wish to continue taking art classes. Okay, we've had students do that, and we had to fix that in the scheduling because it's the same course. You can't get credit for it again. Okay. We have photography and digital design. Those are classes and fashion design. So these are just, I'm just giving you the options that are open to freshmen. So if you are interested in art and that is your passion, that is something you're good at, again, using that program of studies, going to the table of contents, and looking at fine arts, and looking at all the different classes we have to offer. We do offer AP Art Studio, so that's offered at the senior level. So if that's something your child wants to take, I would start planning backwards. So how do I get to take to that AP Art Studio class? Health and PE, so these are electives. Just remember they are required electives. So I'll start with health, because that's just easier. All freshmen need to sign up for a health class. Okay, you have to, when you go into the portal, they need to sign up for health. The only way they would get bumped out of it is if they have a class, like some of our students that take the Algebra 1 course, the blocked period. Sometimes those students have a full course load and may not get help on their schedule, then we end up putting some sophomores in there. But regardless, we need to sign up for it as a freshman, so we make sure that we're getting as many freshmen in that health class as possible, because really that is a freshman year requirement. So PE, here's where people have a lot of questions. PE class, so it's recommended you take, if you're going to do the class option, it's recommended that you take one class per year. So freshman year, you sign up for it once, then sophomore year, you sign up for it, and you're done. You got your two classes. They are worth a quarter credit. That's just a state rule that you have to, they can only be worth a quarter credit and then a half credit total. The PE waiver. So this is what a lot of students choose to do, and for different reasons. Maybe they don't want to take a PE class. They're already doing sports. It takes away time in your schedule. Like if you're someone who really is passionate about art or music or whatever it may be, you want to take a foreign language, you want to do some more electives, getting that PE out of the way can be helpful because it opens up a semester's worth of time. So in order to be eligible for the PE waiver, you must participate in 90% of the sports season for two seasons of sports, okay? May be completed in 1 year, it does not have to. So again, students must be participating in two seasons of a sport. So this could be many different ways. Your student could play football in the fall and baseball in the spring, and they're done. They've completed it in 1 year, okay? The only rule to this is that they must participate in 90% of the season. So if they get hurt, and they don't participate, the coach says it wasn't 90%, that we have to go off of what the coaches put for their roster, okay? You don't earn any credit when you do the PE waiver. There's no credits earned, it's just a waiver saying you've met the PE requirement for the state. We highly encourage you, again, to be done with this by your 10th grade year, because if not, we start putting you in a PE class, because we can't afford, it's happened less and less, because we as counselors have got, we've really gotten on kids about doing this, but I'll tell you what, my first couple years, I had seniors that had to do a full year of PE, because they just put it off, and they didn't do a sport they said they were going to do, they didn't take the class as a sophomore, so then they were a senior in a PE course. They weren't happy, but they wanted to graduate, so that was our only choice. So again, I would strongly recommend you get that done by the end of your 10th grade year. Music, if you're someone who is currently in our music program at the middle school, or you're thinking about it, we have that does count as a fine art credit. So remember, you need full credit fine art. We have our band class, which is a four-year course. We have choir, which again is a full-year course, so again, counting as that fine art. And then we have a music theory course that our choir teacher teaches, and that is a semester-long class. Other fine art electives to consider. year, film studies is a new course this year that our theater teacher will be teaching, and theatrical performance. So again, if you're a theater person or you're trying to get into theater, you want to look at this in the program of studies under drama and theater and see what's the difference. What's the difference between intro to theater and theatrical performance? Okay. And then, like I said, Stagecrafters 1, there is a Stagecrafters 2. So again, if you're someone who's really into theater, you want to see what those classes are like and make sure you're meeting prerequisites to move on in the theater program and our classes. World languages, we offer Spanish and French here. A lot of students are always asking me, wait, I have to have a foreign language to graduate, right? That's not true. I try to tell kids, you know, in high school, being a high school counselor, we have two important jobs, you know, making sure you graduate and then getting you ready for your next step. So getting you ready for your next step, we have a lot of kids here at TIP that are college bound. If you want to go to a four-year college or university, you must have at least 2 years of a foreign language, okay, to enter college. If you're interested in an honors diploma, graduating with honors, you need at least 3 years. So you gotta start kind of backpedaling your head. Okay, well, I need at least 3 years. I better start foreign language by the time I'm a sophomore. In order to take it as a freshman, you need to have a recommendation that comes from your language arts teacher, okay? And you should be averaging a C or higher in language arts. And again, this is just for your, for protection of when you're coming to high school. It's already such a big transition. We want to make sure it's as successful as it can be. So again, just kind of keeping that in mind. We have some of our foreign language teachers here. Did Ms. Ridge or Ms. Robertson, did you want to say anything?
Well, I just want to introduce myself. I'm Mrs. Ridge. I'm one of the Spanish 1 teachers here at the high school. Mr. Rausch is the other one. So if you take Spanish and you have me or him, he's actually outside of our table too. So if you want to stop up there, you can say hi to him. Obviously, you know, I know Mrs. Schmidt mentioned just 2 years of being able to enter a four-year college. But in general, let me just say that Spanish and French are both just practical classes to take. Also, I'll add that we are updating our curriculum for next year. So we're getting new textbooks that are digital, actually. We're really excited about that.
Hi there. I'm Mrs. Robinson. I'm a French teacher here at the high school, French 1 through 4. Would like to put out there that at the French 3 and French 4 level, students are able to get CCP credit by taking French. So they will get one credit for French 3 through St. Clair, and then another credit in French 4. So if CCP is something that you're interested in, that is offered for French 3 and 4. And if you have any questions, please stop out. We've got a table out there also with some information if any of you are interested in traveling abroad.
Thank you. So again, foreign language that tends to be popular elective for a lot of our students. I just think it's fun because you're learning a whole new language. I mean, sometimes I hear them practicing the alphabet or speaking or whatever. So again, that seems to be a really fun elective for students. And as I mentioned, 2 years at least to get to college. Some of the more competitive schools, they really like to see three years. And I know I have a lot of students that come to me as a junior or, they're like, oh, I wish I would have started with a foreign language as a freshman. So if it's something you kind of, you have the ability, you're getting the grade, your teacher has recommended you for it, and you have the ability in your schedule, having that 4 years in the program is really great too. So other electives are applied technology. Lots of opportunities here for students that are interested in tech and computers. We have many classes here. If you were in the earlier presentation about grad requirements, I talked about how fortunate we are that we have CCP tech classes because you can earn a graduation seal through that. So we have a couple classes that the computer science principles and the IT fundamentals, those do not to be taken as College Credit Plus, but then if you notice, must be taken as CCP. All the ones below. business classes. So the classes that fall under that freshmen would be able to take, accounting, career connections. I feel like I've talked about that class a lot. That one is required to graduate for our freshmen and beyond. Intro to business, marketing tech, Microsoft apps, and sports and entertainment marketing. So again, interested in business, there's a lot of electives available under business as well. But again, it's great. You know, I have some students say, well, you know, you put me in, you know, intro to business, you put me in this class, or I don't remember, you know. And then they end up taking it and they learned about a different career field that they didn't even know was, you know, available to them. And I always tell them, you know, it's great, you're at least earning an elective credit, and, you know, maybe find out it's a career for you or it's a career not for you, and that you know, all you had was a semester worth in high school rather than spending a lot of time and money in a college program going for that degree. Yes, marketing tech, which I appreciated. They made some fun videos this year around holidays and just, you know, what are you thankful for on Thanksgiving? And they've just done a lot of good things. It's been fun. So a lot of hands-on activities in that class. Family consumer science, classes available to freshmen with child development, nutrition and wellness, and fashion design. Again, these are all courses in the program of studies if you wanted to read more about them. I will say, you know, nutrition, wellness, foods classes, that seems to be a fan favorite for everyone. Those classes do fill up quickly. We don't have a lot of freshmen in there just because we try to give priority to our juniors and seniors that have been trying to get into the class. So again, that's a huge thing why we tell students in the PowerSchool portal, make sure you're choosing alternates. Because if you can't get to a certain elective, maybe your schedule doesn't permit it, or the class is too full, we will put you in an alternate that you chose. So make sure you're researching and choosing alternates as well.
Can I please say one thing?
Sure.
The nutrition and wellness class is a prerequisite for global foods, which you'll be able to take beyond your freshman year. So if you have any desire to take global foods, a lot of seniors like to save that class to take your senior year. Please make sure that you get the nutrition and wellness course in because it is a prereq for that class. Thank you.
Other considerations to think of when you're scheduling, or when you're talking to your child about scheduling and what classes they're going to choose in PowerSchool. Be thinking about their interests, their abilities, and their skill levels. If you notice, this kind of the yellow sheet that was kind of my, you know, quick tips for scheduling. We do recommend, and this is something that we've kind of just started seeing in the past couple years. And I talked about this when the accelerated teachers and AP teacher talked. We really recommend that you do not take more, especially your freshman year, than 2 accelerated classes. If that's something that you think, accelerated, 2 accelerated AP is appropriate for my child, as long as you're signing off on the verification sheet, which I'll talk about that here in a second, that you're aware of that. But just make sure you're considering, like I said, your students' skills, their abilities, their interests, and just making sure that they're not overdoing it on their course load. Weighted grades, program of studies, making sure you're looking at our accelerated and our AP classes are weighted, so meaning that they do get a little bump in the GPA. NCAA eligibility, so making sure that students are picking courses if they intend to be a college athlete that are NCAA approved. Schedule change policies, so no changes after June 1st. Reason for this is because we create the best master schedule we can based off the request from students. So this is really important because if we have 90 students, you know, sign up for accelerated English, then we're going to look at, okay, geez, you know, about 3 sections of that, 30, that's too many, so then we go ahead and make it 4. Right? I'm just making up numbers here, but and then if we have students who want to back out of that and get put in the CP, now we're making those classes teacher ratio. So after after June 1st, there's more of a process if you're wanting to get your son or daughter's schedule changed, because by then we have schedules done. We're just looking through them to make sure there's no gaps in classes, in a student's schedule, that students are, that all freshmen have in math, science, social science, and English, those kinds of things. So after June 1st, no schedule changes without going through a certain process. So what is the scheduling process? We visited the 8th graders on the 25th and 26th. Online course requests, we have February 18th. We're trying to hold on to that. I know things have gotten pushed back because of closings last week. Ms. Alexander, the counselor at the middle school, she is planning on having open labs during students' write-down period. So if they're having difficulty scheduling, they're not sure how to get on the portal, they're not sure what to pick, she's going to have open labs. I just know she had to move those dates around. So make sure that your son or daughter is looking at those announcements for that, or if you get announcements emailed to you, you'll want to make sure that they attend those open labs if they need help getting on the computer and actually getting their schedule requests in. The verification sheet, so what we're going to do is once your student has put their schedule requests in, we will print them all. And then they will be given their verification sheets, so it'll have listed all the courses they requested. And then we ask that you read those over, sign it, and then your student return it back to their write-down teacher. Okay? That's just kind of our way of doing a final check that you have seen their course requests, that you approved. If there was anything that you needed to change, or that would be something, we'll have directions on the verification sheet when those go home. But just so that you guys are in tune to the process. Okay, so that my son or daughter should be putting in their schedules by the 18th, and then they should be getting a verification form sent home. Like I said, some of these dates may be pushed back a little bit just due to us being closed, but I would definitely say by the end of February we will want this process complete. What questions do we have? Questions about acceptance? We don't recommend that they kind of flip-flop. I know college, in order for the honors diploma, they have to have at least, it's 3 years, and they have to have at least 2 years in the same language. Same for, I believe, most colleges, it has to be 2 years in one language. I had one student that took two languages, but they did like 3 years of one and two of the other, or something like that. Yeah.
Is the course of study that's on the website have the new courses that have been added that's already been updated?
Yes. The only thing that it might say next to it, which isn't relevant to you guys, is LEADS course code. I don't know if that's still on there or not, but that's more for us than it is for parents. It's just the code in the computer. But no, all the new subjects or courses that have been added, they are under Applied Tech. This is Doug talked about. There's a lot of new electives, classes under Applied Tech. All of those are in there. Prereqs, like she brought up a good point. If you want to take global foods, you have to take nutrition and wellness. So make sure thinking about what kind of things interest you or interest your child, and looking at all those courses, like I mentioned with art. If your student wants to take AP art as a senior, what are the prereqs? Kind of work backwards. So yes, all the new courses, all those program, all those descriptions are in the program of studies. What other questions? Yeah. So if your student is not desiring to go to college, or if they want to go to a two-year college, foreign language is not required to get a high school diploma. It is only required if your student wants to get what's called an honors diploma, graduating with academic honors. then they're required to earn 3 years of a foreign language. If your student is desiring to go to a four-year college, or even has the idea that they want to go to a four-year college, then they need to have at least 2 years to get in. They look at their transcripts and they'll make sure they have at least 2 years of a foreign language. I'm sorry. Yeah, so if they want to go to college, they would need it. But yeah, they don't need it to actually earn a diploma. Mm-hmm. And that's what's kind of the, you know, go between, and they tell kids, you know, it's our job to, yeah, so make sure you graduate, get that diploma, but it's also our job to prepare you for the next steps. If you're going into the workforce, what are some of the classes you should be taking here to get you prepared for the workforce? If you want to go to CTC, as a junior and senior, what are classes you should be taking to get to your program? If you want to go to a four-year college and, you know, and go into a medical field, what classes should you be taking here to get you the best transcript? Good questions. Yep.
Yeah, on the paper it says a portal opens this week to sign up for their classes. What portal is it?
Power School.
Power School.
Yes. Power School. And we'll be posting, so the eighth graders do now have a Google Classroom that's managed by the high school counselors. So we will be posting, like I'll post this PowerPoint. It's pretty, I adapted it a little bit, but this was pretty much the PowerPoint we presented to the eighth graders. I'll post the scheduling sheet that you guys got today, the yellow sheet, I'll post that to the Google Classroom. And I know students are able to invite their parents to a Google Classroom, so if that's something you want to be part of and see what's being posted, that the class of 2026 now has a Google Classroom. That's something they'll keep, you know, active when we're constantly posting stuff, whether it's to all grades or if it's senior specific, we post to the senior classroom, those kinds of things. So yeah, the scheduling, the portal should open up later this week, and then, like I said, probably next week, there'll be open labs. So I would just pay attention to Ms. Alexander's announcements on when those labs would be. She'll have time that kids would be coming down in school to schedule.
Will that be available on the app, or do we have to go online?
I think that's, I don't know how the app is, it's different. I think it's probably pretty hard to do it on the app, but they can do it at home. They don't have to be in school doing it. It's something you can sit home with them and do. She's just having open labs for students who are having difficulty doing it. Or maybe a class isn't coming up or something like that. It's just kind of give that extra support. But they certainly don't have to attend.